So with the end of Jujutsu Kaisen's second anime season with the Shibuya incident arc, I figured I would go back and look at different arcs and rank every character that we see from those arcs from weakest to strongest. For this video, I'll be talking about the Goodwill event, and there are a few things I'd like to address first before we get started. The first thing is that I won't be including any of the adults on this list, as not only would some of the placements be predictable and boring, like Gojo for example, but they don't really have on-screen fights like that compared to the students, and I also want to include characters that we actually see fight. Secondly is that I will only be using feats, statements, and information about the characters from before and up to the end of the Goodwill event, so anything that happens afterwards I will not be including in my ranking. And thirdly, unlike my previous ranking videos, for this one I'll be ranking everyone based off of tiers instead of direct numbers, as I feel it would be easier and I can give more information for each character. And as always, please don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, and comment to help support me and the channel. And with all of that being said, let's get into the weakest person on this list, starting with the F tier. Now for F tier, we have Mai Zenin, and during the Goodwill event arc, she isn't really that impressive, like, at all. She got physically restrained by Nobara, who also in terms of physical strength is one of the weakest characters within this arc, and Mai also has the worst showings out of everyone on this list, and all she really does have is just her construction curse technique, which isn't really that impressive all things considered, only because she can make one bullet with it and that's about it. And I firmly believe that if she were to battle anyone else above her on this list, that she would lose pretty concretely, so that's why I have Mai at F tier. Next is D tier, and for this tier, I have Nobara, Momo, and Miwa. In my opinion, I do believe that these three are all interchangeable to a degree, as they all have feats that make them somewhat relative to each other. But I'll start with Miwa first and why I have her above Mai. So Miwa is an average close quarters combatant. She isn't the best or anything like that, but she isn't really that bad either. She can somewhat react to and keep up with Maki, who is blatantly above Mai as shown in their fight, and she also has some pretty unique sword techniques that I do believe if she were to pull off against Mai, that she would literally have no way to counter in battle against Miwa. And as I said, Mai also couldn't keep up with or outbox Maki in hand-to-hand combat, and is pretty much only good at long-range battles. So if it comes down to a close quarters fight, I believe Miwa should have the edge on Mai and should beat her if they fight. While if it's long range, then I do think that Mai would be able to win, although I have my money more times than not on Miwa. Next is Momo, and in my opinion, she is a slight step up compared to Mai in terms of being a long range fighter. She is able to use her cursed energy to manipulate wind in conjunction with her broom to attack her opponents. And when looking at a battle between Momo and Mai, I genuinely don't think Mai would be able to hit her since she is so high up in the air. And if Mai runs out of bullets, she would only be able to construct one cursed energy bullet, and should she miss, it's really the end of the fight right there. Plus, I believe that if Momo is able to hit Mai with one of her wind attacks, then she would get folded on the spot, no contest. But there is a chance that Mai could possibly trick Momo into getting closer to her to hit her with the bullet, but Momo is pretty cautious and wouldn't really try to get too close to Mai, especially knowing what she can do, so that's why I have her higher than Mai. But if you think that Mai is somehow able to hit Momo and Miwa with her bullets, then she can win, although I find that highly unlikely. And as for Nobara, we already saw how her fight with Momo went, and she was going to knock her out if it wasn't for interference from Mai, and Nobara was able to physically restrain Mai while Megumi and Toto were fighting, and I'm pretty sure had Nobara actually had her weapons on her, then she would have beat Mai with little to no difficulty. So that's why I have these three ranked above her. Next is C tier, and for this tier I have Naruto Shikamo and Inumaki. Now unlike the previous tier, I do believe that Kamo is above Inumaki due to a number of reasons. First is because he actually knows about Inumaki's cursed speech and has studied its effects and how it works. He does say a few times that if you aren't aware of when it's coming, then it's a dangerous technique, and that in order to counter it, you need to be able to protect your ears and brain with curse energy. This is also not mentioning the fact that Kamo can dope himself up and not only increase his visual acuity during combat, but can also increase his strength and speed as well by manipulating his blood. This gives him a pretty good physical advantage, as he used this to go from being relative or equal to a holding back Megumi to then pressing this same Megumi and putting him on the back foot to force him to use more of his Shikigamis. And Kamo has his arrows, which he can use his blood on top of to further increase its speed while in flight. which gives him a range advantage as well. And he has his pack of blood that he can use to refill himself with blood so he doesn't run out. It's also important to note that Kama was using all of this while also holding himself back against Megumi, which he later confirms, and was going to get serious against them had Hanami not interfered in the fight, which he was also able to damage them as well. And Principal Gakuganji believes that if Kama were to fight Toto in a 1v1, he would win the fight, although coming out with many injuries. Now, I don't think I need to explain why this statement is just wrong, but Kama was going relative or equal to Megumi, who got completely destroyed by Toto and was planning on bringing out Maharaga just to fight him. So I wouldn't take that statement literally. And as for Inumaki, I have him lower than Kamo since Kamo has counters to his cursed speech, which really is all Inumaki has going for him, and he wasn't able to really damage Hanami in any significant way, only using commands like don't move and stop, and when he used his command blast away, Hanami had no visible injuries on him. So this is why I have these two at C tier. Now we're at B tier, and for this tier I have Panda and Mekamaru. And because we already saw this fight between these two, I have Panda being on top of this tier, with Mekamaru being second. But I do want to explain why I have these two above C tier, and I'll begin with Panda. Now we don't know for sure if Panda is aware of the counter to curse speech, but even if he isn't, he should be more than capable to possibly use his intellect and ingenuity to get past and defeat Inumaki. Panda also has his gorilla mode, which when he uses this, he has a technique called unblockable drumming beat. It can bypass durability and attack the opponent from the inside out, as it's pure sound, which should also work on Inumaki. And Panda also has superior stats, as he should be able to outbox and outspeed him in close quarters combat. And Mekamaru is able to combat against Panda and has his ultimate cannon, which if it were to hit Inumaki, I'm pretty sure I don't need to say this, but like, you know how Inumaki always talks about like salmon and like, you know, like fish foods and stuff. He'd literally be fish paste. Plus, it's important to mention that Mekamaru knows how to counter curse speech, so he would be able to use that to nullify its effects, and the rest is history, which is why I have them at B tier. Next is A tier, and I have Maki and Megumi, and I know some of y'all are seeing Megumi right here, and y'all are like, yo, Captain, what are you smoking? Are you stupid? And I'm just here to say that, no, I am not stupid, and I have an explanation for this, so let me explain. And just in case anybody somehow has a problem with Megumi being below Maki, let me also address this too, because I swear I've seen people argue this version of Megumi over Maki. Maki has her heavily restriction, which basically makes her superhuman. And Megumi, someone who is considered a genius and is super smart, says that if it came down to a battle of hand-to-hand combat with no cursed energy whatsoever, then Yuji would win. And he says this while Maki is also in the same room, and she doesn't even deny this statement. Many of you might be quick to bring up that he hadn't seen Maki fight up until this point and had no basis for this claim, but the problem is that he actually did end up fighting alongside her directly against Hanami later, and he also saw what she was capable of there, and he still didn't retract the statement, which should mean that it is indeed true. And Maki herself concedes inferiority to Toto, and verbatim says herself that if everyone were to try to fight and gang up on him, that he would just beat them all, and recommends Yuji to either beat him or hold him off. So yeah, Maki is weaker than Yuji and Toto. But anyways, back to Megumi, I have him higher than everybody else lower due to his insanely high battle IQ and versatility with his curse technique. I can easily see him beating everyone below him with just that. Not to mention that he was holding his own pretty well against Kamo while he was doping. And when Megumi started to get serious, he actually forced Kamo himself to get serious before their battle was interrupted. And why I have him above the likes of Panda and Mekamaru is because of his showcase against Hanami. Not only was Megumi able to physically react to them during the battle, but he was able to somewhat damage them and even do combo attacks with Maki, who he was also keeping pace with, and Megumi's sword that he was using was actually able to harm Hanami, and Hanami actually acknowledges that power that the sword has. And Momo says that she can't believe Maki and Megumi got hurt as bad as they did against Hanami, which should show that she places those two in a somewhat high regard. And the reason why Maki is above Megumi is all of the previous reasons I mentioned before, and the fact that she was able to significantly damage Hanami's arm with Playful Cloud, and was acknowledged to have more striking power than pre-Black Flash Yuji, which is why I have these two at A tier. And finally, we're at S tier, and for this tier, I have Hanami, Yuji, and Toto. These three are pretty much the strongest characters within this arc, excluding Gojo of course, and have the feats to back it up. Hanami was able to keep up with and battle against both Yuji and Toto, people who Hanami actually admit are stronger than everybody else they fought up until that point, which is evident when they say that they're going to start trying during the fight, and they're durable enough to keep surviving attacks from Yuji and Toto, who they say is able to harm them individually. And keep in mind, this is a Yuji who landed 4 consecutive black flashes on Hanami, which increases the power of the hit by 2.5 times, and Hanami was still able to keep on battling. And this isn't even mentioning fun amp Hanami, in which their abilities became even more deadly and Hanami was putting even more effort into the fight. Keep in mind, Yuji and Toto are both equal to each other, with the case of Yuji being just a little bit stronger than Toto during this time. The same Toto that everyone else was hyping up throughout this entire arc. The same Toto that didn't use his curse technique against multiple grade 1 curses and only used it on a special grade. And that everyone says Yuji is the only one who can possibly fight him. And Hanami is above them both simply because of their power, durability, and their domain expansion. Even though we haven't seen what it is up until this point in the anime, we can get an idea of it if you've played the Jujutsu Kaisen Phantom Parade game, which shows that Hanami summons a flower field which makes the target lose the will to fight, and the sure hit is seemingly either the flower bud on Hanami's shoulder that can fire a beam of curse energy, or is the buds that can drain someone of curse energy when they impale somebody. And Yuji and Toto were able to push Hanami into using their domain expansion when no one else could, until Gojo came in and ruined everything. Anyway, that's it for my Goodwill event ranking list, and I hope you all enjoyed the video. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, and comment to support me and the channel. And if you'd like to see another JJK video, then check out my Luffy vs. Mahiraga video. Or if you would like to watch my last video, then you can check out my Broly vs. Beast Gohan video. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Take care.